Introducing RoboParkour, a 7-part breakthrough AI system that's enabling robots to master the art of parkour, a feat previously confined to highly skilled humans. And no, this isn't some kind of programming gimmick, but instead it's a bona fide robotics innovation that's backed by a meticulous research paper, and you won't believe what it can do. But to set the stage, let's first understand the quandary researchers have grappled with for years. Teaching robots to perform complex physical tasks. Picture a robot navigating an intricate maze, or better yet, executing parkour stunts. Parkour requires a blend of skill sets such as climbing, jumping, and tilting, all executed with seamless coordination and real-time decision-making, attributes not readily associated with traditional robots. So, what are the 7 parts that make RoboParkour different, and how do they work? Number 1. Two-stage reinforcement learning. This innovation lies in a two-stage framework featuring soft dynamics constraints in the initial training phase. By incorporating these constraints, researchers expedite the learning curve, rendering a more efficient process which was once a bottleneck in the RL realm. Indeed, this distinct strategy forms the linchpin of RoboParkour's unprecedented learning proficiency. Number 2. Specialized skill policies. The cornerstone of agility. The researchers leverage a combination of recurrent neural networks and multilayer perceptrons to create specialized skill policies that form the cornerstone of RoboParkour. These policies process a deluge of sensory inputs, from depth images to proprioceptive data, enabling the robot to interpret its environment in real time and react accordingly. Number 3. Isaac Gym, the ideal training ground. Isaac Gym, a state-of-the-art simulator, serves as the training ground where robots cut their teeth in parkour. With 40 different tracks filled with a myriad of obstacles, this virtual setting is the ideal arena for mastering varying complexities involved in the sport. Number 4. Reward structures, the invisible hand. To steer the robot in the desired behavioral direction, researchers use meticulously crafted reward structures that focus on various parameters, such as velocity, energy conservation, and obstacle penetration. These carefully calibrated rewards provide the motivation for the robots to excel in their tasks, all while discouraging undesirable actions. Number 5. Closing the simulation-reality gap, a quantum leap forward. Transferring the skills learned in simulated environments to real-world applications is the ultimate challenge. Here, domain adaptation techniques come into play, enabling the robot to adapt its skills and perform in real-world scenarios. Number 6. The crucial role of vision. Seeing is believing. What truly sets RoboParkour apart is its use of vision sensors, like depth cameras, to equip the robot with the ability to perceive its environment. This integration enables the robot to adapt and make dynamic decisions as they approach and overcome obstacles. Number 7. Unmatched performance metrics. Stats don't lie. When pitted against existing methods, RoboParkour emerges triumphant. Robots trained using this innovative approach demonstrated markedly higher success rates in complex tasks like climbing and leaping. Recurrent neural networks have proven to be indispensable, especially for tasks requiring memory and sequential reasoning. Number 8. The three-staged approach. The first stage involves reinforcement learning pre-training with soft dynamics constraints, allowing robots to gradually learn how to navigate complex obstacles. The second stage takes this learning a notch higher. With RL fine-tuning that enforces hard dynamics constraints for realistic behaviors. Finally, the third stage employs a technique called Dagger to distill these skills into a unified vision-based parkour policy. This policy allows legged robots to deploy their newfound agility using only onboard perception and computation power. Finally, in the future, this research could spark a revolution in robotic capabilities, setting the stage for robots to take on increasingly complex roles in diverse real-world scenarios. The broader implications are tantalizing, from rescue missions in treacherous terrains to advanced automation in industries. Meanwhile, one of the most exciting developments is happening at the intersection of machine learning and visual perception. A team of MIT researchers has unveiled EfficientViT, a next-generation computer vision model that could very well change the way machines see and interact with the world around them. This is not just another incremental update to existing technologies. It's a groundbreaking innovation that promises to turbocharge a wide array of applications, from autonomous driving to medical imaging. One of the major challenges facing traditional computer vision technologies, particularly vision transformers, is their computational complexity. For these systems to work, they rely on an attention mechanism that unfortunately scales quadratically, rendering the real-time processing of high-resolution images nearly impossible on current edge devices. This limitation is critical when you consider the applications at stake: autonomous vehicles navigating through intricate urban landscapes, or medical AI systems that need to accurately identify tumors from scans, for instance. These use cases depend heavily on semantic segmentation, the practice of tagging and categorizing every single pixel in an image to identify and understand objects within it. Enter EfficientViT, which tackles this problem head-on by re-engineering the attention mechanism that lies at the heart of these vision systems. Unlike its predecessors, EfficientViT employs a method of creating attention maps in a simplified way. These maps capture the relationships between different parts of an image, allowing the model to form what is known as a global receptive field. In this manner, the model can access all relevant areas of an image at once, offering a more comprehensive understanding of the scene. Additionally, EfficientViT uses a linear function to handle computational complexity instead of the non-linear functions traditionally used. This might sound like a small tweak, but it's monumental in terms of impact. It means that computational complexity rises in a linear fashion, not quadratically. This adjustment leads to significant increases in speed and efficiency, making real-time processing a tangible reality. But what about the trade-off between speed and accuracy, you might wonder? The researchers have already thought of that. While linear functions can indeed capture the global context of an image, they fall a bit short in capturing local nuances. To address this, the MIT team integrated two additional components designed to capture local features as well as objects of varying sizes. This dual approach helps maintain a high level of accuracy while benefiting from the speed gains of the new linear function. In tests, its capabilities were fully demonstrated, and the model performed as well as, or even better, than less efficient but more complex models. Plus, it did so up to 9 times faster.